الصبح بدا من طلعته والليل دجا من وفرته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته الله 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 الله
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Peace and salutations be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Respected viewers of ITV Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh Welcome to another edition of the program Riyadus Saliheen Gardens of the Righteous And we welcome day 27 of the blessed month of Ramadan and we hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us all the opportunity of searching for the fourth time for the night of power, the night better than a thousand months and we have just one more opportunity that is to follow and that is the 29th night of the month of Ramadan. That's the last opportunity that we have to search for the night of power and that also could be the last opportunity that we would get in our life to search for the night of power because absolutely no one has any guarantee that they will live to see another month of Ramadan. In fact, life is so short that we're on the 27th of the month of Ramadan, so we've just witnessed the fourth odd night, but yet we don't have any guarantee that we're going to see the last odd night of the month of Ramadan. That's how short life is. And from the first of the month of Ramadan to where we are right now, we know how many people have also passed away and have left the world unexpectedly. We never thought that that would happen, but it was the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah knows best as to how long we're going to live and how much more life we have to live in this world. We all are well acquainted with our date of birth. Nobody knows when they're going to leave this world. So we've witnessed the fourth night of the month of Ramadan. We hope and pray that we reach the fifth night of the month of Ramadan. But beyond that, we don't know whether we will see another month of Ramadan in our lives. And we have a few hours left. So inshallah, maybe we should all try in some way or the other. We know that we have so many responsibilities and we have so many things that we need to take care of, but we're coming to the end. If there's a possibility in some way or the other of us now going a step further and just shifting the gear and exerting ourselves more than we've already exerted ourselves. I know you must be wondering that that's what I'm speaking about all along, only about going up. And we said that the first portion of the month of Ramadan and the second portion, we've did whatever we needed to do. Now we need to exert ourselves for the last 10 days. But now we need to find that little more steam within ourselves. It's right at the end. We come into the finish line. You know, I use this example sometimes for people to understand that if we look at a race that takes place, right, or you take a match that takes place, the end, what happens at the end? That is the most critical point. That is the most important. The last few moments, everybody is in a frenzy. Everybody is giving off every bit of what they possibly could contain within themselves. In fact, sometimes they go beyond that. Because when you come to the end, we notice sometimes people would collapse right at the end. Why? Because they went more over and above what they could possibly do. They exerted themselves right till the last breath of strength that they had within them. So they reach the end and they literally drop out of exhaustion. So we come into the end of the month of Ramadan. I'm not saying that now we need to drop out of exhaustion and faint because we got the blessed day of Eid that we also need to enjoy. And we need to be happy on the day that Allah has commanded us to be happy. But what I'm saying is, it's the last few moments. Let's show Allah our enthusiasm. Allah looks at the end. That's the most important. Let's show Allah that, oh Allah, we're desperate for your mercy. Oh Allah, we want to be close to you. Oh Allah, we want to make you happy. And we're going to do whatever it takes, inshallah, to make you happy. On the program Riyadu Saliheen, we had concluded in the last edition of the program the narration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that told us of how amazing and how wonderful the life of every believer is. Irrespective of the outward apparent condition, life is good for you because if Allah has favored you, you must be grateful to Him and there could be no better condition that could come upon you because you've recognized Allah and you've drawn closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at the same token, if life is difficult, life is constrained upon you, and you're going through many, many challenges, and you feel that you don't know how long more you can cope up, and you have nowhere to turn to, then you're patient upon the difficulty and hardship, and you go and you find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you rush back to Allah. That's the best condition that could have come upon you, because you found Allah, you reached your destination, which is attaining the pleasure of Allah, and inshallah you will reach the ultimate destination of the eternal gardens of Jannah that Allah has prepared for the believers. Today's narration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the new narration that we move over to, under the chapter of patience, is something very, very important. Many people out there in the world are struggling to cope with this very difficult challenge that comes upon people in this world. Among the many, many challenges that we will face in this world, the many painful separations that we all will endure or have to endure in this world, the separation of you being separated from somebody that you love, from you being separated from a family member, among the most painful separations and amongst the most difficult challenges that come upon us in our journey through life, is the difficulty and the hardship and the separation from a parent to their children. When our children are separated from us, when our children are taken away in this world, when we have to bury our own children, that is the most painful, that is the most difficult challenge that could ever come upon us in this world. Why is it the most difficult? Why is it the most painful? Because when you're still there at the top and you have to separate from the one beneath you, it's always very, very hard, very difficult. Somebody once told me, in terms of trying to console another individual or sharing the pain of somebody that had lost their child, he said that this is such a difficult condition. That, remember, the parent is at the top and the child is at the bottom. When you lose the one at the bottom, he said, when you drop your head from losing the one at the bottom, it's literally almost impossible to lift your head up there again thereafter. That's how sore it is. That's how painful it is. And this is the narration that we're going to begin discussing now on the program Riyadus Saliheen. This is what is going to be the focus, in fact, over the next few editions on the program Riyadus Saliheen, where we look at this challenge in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And when we go through challenges, remember, one of the greatest consolations that we take in the midst of those challenges is that the closest, most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most perfect human being, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, went through the same challenges. If we feel we have been tested with our health, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was also tested at times with his health. If we feel that we are tested with people being against us, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also went through the same difficulty. In fact, read through the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, see the challenges that he faced, and that then you will take consolation. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that I have been made to go through challenges more difficult than anybody has ever gone through in the whole of humanity. So if you think you had it bad, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was tested a lot more. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was patient. So when it comes to this painful aspect of the separation of our children, that is something sore, that is something difficult. But as difficult as it is, the grandness of the reward that has been promised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to go through that difficulty and to go through that hardship is worth every second of it. When you look at the reward that you get in at the end, it's worth going through that challenge. Not that we ask for that challenge. May Allah protect our children, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and save us from going through that difficulty. That's for those who have not gone through it. For those who have gone through the challenge, you will really relate and you will enjoy these narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when I say enjoy, I mean it in a way that it's so soothing. It's so comforting. There's so much of solace that you can take from these words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that it would really be of benefit to us if we have gone through that very painful and very difficult separation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with each and every one of us. That brings us to the end of today's edition of the program Riyadus Saliheen, Gardens of the Righteous. Join us again on another edition. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الليل دجى من وفرته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا